In this lesson, we'll talk about Power Boost, which is a traffic-shaping mechanism that was first deployed in commercial broadband networks in June 2006 by Comcast. So Power Boost allows a subscriber to send at a higher rate for a brief period of time. So if you subscribed at a rate of 10 megabits per second, then Power Boost might allow you to send at a higher rate for some period of time before being shaped back to the rate at which you were subscribed at. So Power Boost targets the spare capacity in the network for use by subscribers who don't put a sustained load on the network. There are two types of Power Boost. If the rate at which the user can achieve during this burst window is set to not exceed a particular rate, then we say that the policy is capped Power Boost. Otherwise, the policy or the shaping is called uncapped Power Boost. Now, in the uncapped setting, the configuration is simple, and as we described in the last lesson, the area here is the Power Boost bucket size. That's the maximum amount of traffic that can be sent that exceeds the sustained rate. The maximum sustained traffic rate is simply rho, as we've defined it before. Now, suppose that we wanted to cap the rate that the sender could send during the Power Boost window. Well, all we need to do in that case is to simply apply a second token bucket with another value of rho. That token bucket limits the peak sending rate for Power Boost eligible packets to the rate rho c, where rho c is larger than rho. Remember that this value of rho also affects how quickly tokens can refill in the bucket. So it also plays a role in the maximum rate that can be sustained during a Power Boost window.